We were reaching the consecration after the prayer of the Hankiji tour. We have now page 48 in our booklet, this booklet of the Mass. We have this prayer, Quam Oblationem. Actually, we have seen this prayer last time. Let us just go quickly through it. Quam oblationem tu, Deus in omnibus, quesumus benedictam, ascriptam, ratam, rationabilem, acceptabilem quae, facere dineris, which oblation, quam oblationem, do thou, O God, to Deus, in omnibus, in all things, quesumus, we wish say, to bless, benedictam, approve, ascriptam, ratam, ratify, rationabilem, acceptabilem, quae facere dineris, that you deign, make worthy, rationabilem, and acceptabilem, acceptable. This oblation, that it may become for us the body, ut nobis, ut for us, fiat, may become, fiat, corpus, the body, et sanguis, and the blood, sanguis, the blood, dilectissimi filii tui, Domini nostri Jesu Christi, of your beloved, most beloved, dilectissimi, filii, your son, to be your son, Domini nostri Jesu Christi, our Lord, Jesus Christ. At this moment, we are going to start the moment of the consecration. That is now the heart of the Mass. This is the goal. We are reaching the center of the Mass when we are going to do the transubstantiation. It means we convert the substance of the bread into the substance of Jesus. And when we do this transubstantiation, at the same moment, we realize these two aspects of the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist, the aspect of the sacrifice, because when we have this transubstantiation, we have also this mystery of the death of our Lord Jesus Christ. Why? Because when we do this transubstantiation, we do it twice. We do it for the body, and we do it for the blood. It means on the altar, through this double consecration, we separate mystically the body and the blood. And what is happening when you separate the body and the blood? This is the death of someone. And this is why we have a double consecration. Because if the goal of the Mass was only to make Jesus present on the altar without renewing the sacrifice of the cross, only one consecration will be enough to make, because, you know, under the host you have also the blood, you have the soul of Jesus, you have his divinity, his humanity present. And even under in the chalice, you have not only the precious blood, but you have Jesus living fully, totally present. But now, we organize, the church has organized, or Christ has done it like that, to have this double consecration, to express mystically the separation of the body and the blood, and not to realize this mystery of the sacrifice, of the renewal of the sacrifice, this mystical death that is happening again in our altar. This is the importance of this double consecration. That is making, of course, Christ present, but also renew his sacrifice, renew his death. And it's not just to commemorate his death, it is really to renew it actually, at this moment, on the altar. And there is a big difference between the traditional Mass and the Novus Ordo. Because if you know, in the modern Mass, the priest is just telling the story on a continuous stone, a load, actually, and he just says what is happening. The day before, he suffered, he took bread into his holy and venerable hands, and having raised his eyes to heaven, to thee, God, this Almighty Father, giving thanks to thee, he blessed it, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying that, take and eat ye all of this, for this is my body. They just tell the story like that, in a continuous and equal tone of voice. In the traditional Mass, it's very different, because all this prayer, that is this this last prayer where we remember what Jesus did just before the consecration, yes, we say the same prayer. But at the end of this prayer, we stop. We stop, it's not anymore a story, it's not anymore to remember what happened. Now we stop and we start acting. Even in the missal of the priest, you can see the character become completely different when it's written Hoc est enim corpus meum. We use a very big character. The priest, after this prayer, he stops, and now he consecrates in an action that he is going to do now. It's not anymore the story. There is a stop, and now he is going to act. Actually, because if you say, like we do in the modern, they do in the modern Mass, they say, he gave to his disciples, saying, take and eat ye all of this, for this is my body. Now this is a story that we are telling, isn't it? What happened? For us it's different. We stop, take, and eat ye all of this. And now the priest, in persona Christi, it means in the person of Christ, he stops the story and now he starts acting like another Christ. He starts acting in persona Christi, in the person of Christ, and he says, this is my body. This is my body. And it's not anymore the story when Christ was saying, this is my body. It is now Christ saying, now, at this moment, taking this bread and saying, this is my body. And that is not a story. This is what is happening now. It is an action that Christ does now through the priest. But you can see the priest is not saying, this is the body of Jesus. No. He is saying, this is my body. And I don't know if you understand this difference between the fact to tell a story from the past in a continuous tone of voice without stopping, and now it's a story from the past, a commemoration, or you stop, and now the priest acts. The priest offers the sacrifice, and through this double consecration, he renews the death of Jesus in a mystical way on the altar, and makes it a sacrifice. Through this double consecration, he separates the body and the blood in a mystical death. And now we realize the sacrifice of the cross. And this is the core of the Mass, of course, of the Mass as a sacrifice, and also the consequence of this consecration is now to possess, to have on our altar the true body of our Lord Jesus Christ present and staying, and now we can even later on receive it. And you remember this sacrifice for the sin, offered for the sins, under the Old Testament, you kill the victim, you offer a part of the victim to God, and you eat the other part, and that is now a meal that you share with God in sign of the recovered friendship, in sign of peace. You share a meal with God, you offer a part of the victim when you burn it, or you offer it, or you sacrifice it, and that is offered to God. And you eat a part of the victim as a sign of reconciliation and peace. It was the meaning of the sacrifice in the Old Law. And for us also, we sacrifice our Lord Jesus Christ during the Mass. And in the communion, we eat the victim, we eat Christ, we receive him as a food. And that is a symbol of our unity and love with Jesus. And this peace given to the world, this forgiveness coming from the sacrifice. Now let us go for this prayer, page 48. Qui pridie quam pater etu? Qui, who, pridie is the day before. The day before. Pridie. Dies is the day. In Latin, dies, diem, et pri is for pre, pre is before, the day before. Qui, who, pridie the day before, quam, pater etur, quam is for the day before, this day, that pater etur is suffered. Passion is coming from patere, passus, passion of Christ, that is coming from this Latin word patere, passio, that is suffering. Who, the day before that he suffered, accepit, he took, panem. Panem is the bread in Latin. Panis, panem. Panis Angelorum, the bread of the angel. He took, accepit, panem, the bread, in, sanctas, holy, ac venerabiles, venerable, manus suas, his hands. He took, in his holy and venerable hand, et elevatis oculis, in celum, and raising his eyes, elevatis is to raise, oculis the eyes, in celum to heaven, ad is to, is a direction, te is you, to you, deum patrem suum, deum God, patrem the Father, suum is. And having raised his eyes to heaven, to the God, is sum omnipotentem almighty Deum Patrem to you God is Almighty Father. Ate Deum suum is omnipotentem almighty Patrem Father. Tibi gratias agens. Tibi to you gratias agere, gratias agens is to give thanks. Giving thanks to you, tibi gratias agens. Benedixit, he blessed. Fregit, he broke. Dedit, quae. No, when you have a word like that, dedit quae, this quae is to say and. It means he blessed, he broke, and he gave. In Latin, dare is to give. Do das dare, dedit, he gave. He gave. And he gave. Discipulis suis. Suis is discipulis disciple. He gave to his disciples. Dicens, that is saying. Saying, dicere, dictum, dicens, that is saying. Accipite, receive. Et manducate and it. Ex hoc is from that. Ex is from, hoc is from that. Omnes, all of you. Accipite tec, et and manducate it, ye all of this. But ex hoc, from that, all of you. And now this word of the consecration. Hoc est enim corpus meum, that are the Latin word of the consecration. Hoc this est is. Enim is, we don't translate this enim. This enim is just to reinforce in Latin. But when we translate, we never translate this enim in, because it's just, maybe you, it's not truly, it's less strong than truly. If we wanted to say that in Latin, we would say hoc est vere, no, vere corpus meum, it's truly my body. But enim is just a slight reinforcement. But we don't have a word for that and we don't translate it. Hoc, this is, est, corpus meum, my body. At this moment, the consecration, the first part of the consecration is done. The real presence is there. Under the host, we have now the real presence of our Lord Jesus Christ. But the sacrifice is not offered yet, because we have not consecrated the wine that has not become the blood of Jesus, and the two species have not been separated mystically through the double consecration. At this moment, Christ is present under the host, but the sacrifice is not fully offered. The priest genuflects and adore Jesus, our God, present in the sacred host. And at this moment, we really adore God, really, substantially present in the Holy Eucharist. It's important to state that we believe in the real presence of God. It's what we call a substantial presence. Christ is present with its own substance. And the substance is what determines an individual. Christ is present, not with his accident. The accident is what can change, but with his substance, that is really himself. And this substance is there. His person is present. And we adore his presence. He genuflects to express the adoration of the divinity, and then he reverently lifts up the host and he shows it to the people that they may adore in their turn. He then places it back on the corporal and genuflects again. The priest always genuflects before and after to handle the Holy Eucharist. Even when the priest wants to, even only to open the ciborium, because he's going to act on the Holy Eucharist, he genuflects before, he opens the ciborium and genuflects after. We always have this double genuflection before and after any action on the Holy Eucharist. That is really to express our faith, to express our respect and our adoration to our Lord Jesus Christ. Now we multiply this sign of respect and adoration, and we need that to keep our faith growing and not to lose our faith. Now we go to the second part of this consecration. Simili modo. Simili is in like manner. Yes. Simili modo, in like manner. Modo is the mode, manner here. Simili modo postquam. After, post, cenatum est, it's, he had taken the supper, he had supped. Accipiens, taking, et hunc preclarum calicem. Taking also, et, hunc preclarum calicem, this excellence preclarum, excellence chalice, in sanctas ac venerabiles manus suas, in suas his, sanctas ac venerabiles holy and venerable hands manus. Item is again. Item, tibi gratias agens, giving you thanks. Gratias agens, to give thanks, tibi to you. And now we speak to the Eternal Father, huh? because the sacrifice is offered to God, and now Christ offering to his Father. Benedixit, he blessed, deditque and he gave, discipulis suis, his disciple, dicens, saying, accipite et bibite ex eo omnes, accipite, receive, take, et bibite and drink, ex eo from that, omnes, all of you. And now the formula of consecration for the precious blood. Hic est enim calix sanguinis mei. Hic est. This is enim. This is the same word. Calix sanguinis mei, the chalice of my blood, sanguinis mei, of my blood, novi et eterni testamenti. Novi is new, eterni is eternal, testamenti is testament. See the chalice of my blood, of the new and everlasting testaments. Mysterium fidei, mystery of faith, mystery of faith. And these words are expressing what is happening. It's a mystery of faith. And maybe the greatest mystery we have, this daily renewal of the holy sacrifice of the cross on our altar. Mystery, mysterium fidei, mystery of faith. We are not just attending a simple commemoration, because a simple commemoration is not a mystery of faith. It's a commemoration, and we just do a commemoration. But now we attend, actually at this moment, we are not anymore here in Kenya, we are in Jerusalem, we are at the foot of the cross, and we attend this moment where Christ gave his life for us. We attend this moment of the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ. And this is a mystery of faith. How can you attend this moment? You are not present, you are not at the foot of the Calvary, really in Jerusalem. You are 2,000 years after. How can you attend this moment? Yes, you can. Yes, you attend this moment. And this is a mystery of faith. This is the mystery of the Mass. This is why this word, Mysterium Fidei, in the consecration of the blood, are so important, because they express this mystery of this sacrifice of Christ that is offered again on our altar. They have removed these two words in the new Mass from the formula of the consecration. And for me, it's something that is absolutely impossible to touch the formula of a sacrament. The formula of sacraments is coming from tradition, coming from the apostles, and the apostles have received this formula from Christ himself. Why have we changed this formula? To remove these two words, mysterium fidei, from the formula of consecration. Actually, these two words, they took them after consecration, and they say the mystery of faith is great, something like that. But we should not touch a formula that is coming from the apostles themselves. And we have no authority to change the formula of the sacraments. Sacraments have been instituted, all of them, by Jesus Christ. They have been given by him to his apostles, and we receive them from tradition. And we have no authority to change the content of the Bible, and we have no authority to change the content of tradition. It is an abuse of authority to change even only one of these words. Mysterium fidei, mystery of faith. Qui pro vobis et pro multis effundetur in remissionem peccatorum. Qui, which, this chalice of his blood, which pro vobis, for you, vobis is you, et pro, for, multis, many, effundetur, is shed, in remissionem peccatorum, in for the remission of the sin. For this is the chalice of my blood of the new and everlasting testament, the mystery of faith, which for you and for many will be shed unto the remission of sins. And now, we have, at the end of this world, we have now completed the double consecration. The sacrifice is offered to God, and the priest genuflects again to adore the precious blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to do also this elevation. When he does the genuflection, he says this words: "Hec cosiescumque feceritis in mei memoriam facietis." These are important words of Jesus himself, just after the institution of the Holy Eucharist. He is giving his apostles the duty to do again these things, to offer again the same sacrifice. Hec, these things, cosiescumque, anytime, every time, feceritis, you do them. Donc, these things, hec, anytime, every time, feceritis, you do them. In mei memoriam facietis, you will do them, or do them, facietis, in mei memoriam, in a memory of me, in my memory. And now we have also the elevation of the chalice, that people can see the chalice, adore Jesus present, and after the priest places it back on the corporal and genuflects again. And now the sacrifice is offered. But we continue the prayer of the canon. This sacrifice is the redemption. The redemption, the death of our Lord Jesus Christ for our sins, to save us from our sins. This sacrifice is offered, as we have said in the canon, for the living, for we have prayed for the church, we have prayed for the Pope, we have prayed for the bishops, we have prayed for all the people who are standing around, and pro omnibus circumstantibus, and for all people around in the assembly. We have prayed for specific people, we say the Mass for. We have also made the commemoration of the Church Triumphant, when we have asked all these saints in heaven to pray for us. That was the preparation. And we have offered this sacrifice also for their glory. After, we have entered in the oblation of the victim with the hankigitur. We have asked God to accept this oblation. We have now realized the sacrifice through the consecration. The double consecration, the sacrifice is realized. And now we continue the Mass. And we continue the prayers that are surrounding this sacrifice. Actually, just after the death of our Lord Jesus Christ that we renew in this sacrifice, we are going to commemorate now his victory. Because there is never death of Jesus without his resurrection and without his victory on death. Because Christ is not defeated by his death, he is victorious because of his resurrection, his victory on death. This is why now, just after his sacrifice, we are going to commemorate his victory, his glorious victory. And immediately after the sacrifice, the death of Jesus, we commemorate this victory. Unde, wherefore, unde demores domine, nos servitui, sed et plebs tua sancta, eusdem Christi fili tui dominostri, tam beate passionis, nec non et ab inferis resurrectionis, sed et in celos gloriose ascensionis, offerimus preclare maestati tue, de tuis donis, accedatis, ostiam puram, ostiam sanctam, ostiam immaculatam, panem sanctum vitae eternae, et calicem salutis perpetue. Unde et memores, wherefore, Domine, O Lord, nos servi tui, us, your servant, servis the servant, nos, us, your servant, sed et plebs tua sancta, sed et is and also, plebs tua sancta, tua is your, plebs is the people, sancta, your holy people. Nos, us, your servant, and also your holy people. Now we are translating at this moment this memores, unde et memores. Now memores is memory, and now we say making this this memory. Eiusdem Christi fili tui dominostri, of the same Christ fili tui your son dominostri our Lord. Tam beate passionis, the blessed beate passionis passion. Donc we do the memory of the blessed passion. Nec non. Nec non is et also. Nec non et also of his resurrection from hell, inferis. Inferis is the where the dead people are. Inferis. It means after the death of Jesus, we say that his soul went to limbo to wait for his resurrection and visit here the people in limbo. And that is this inferis is for this limbo. And ab limbo, or from death, resurrectionist, and from his resurrection from death, sed et, and also in celos gloriose ascensionis, and also is glorious, gloriose, ascensionis ascension, in celos, in heaven. And now we commemorate passion, resurrection and ascension together as a sign of the triumph of Christ over death. Offerimus, we offer, preclare excellence, majestati, majesty, donc we offer to your excellent majesty, de tuis donis, accedatis, de tuis donis, from your gifts. Of thine own gifts, de tuis donis, agdatis, and okay, gift given, hostiam puram, this pure host, hostiam sanctam, this holy host, hostiam immaculatam, this immaculate host, panem sanctum vitae aeternae, holy bread of vitae aeternae, of the eternal life, et calicem salutis perpetuae, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Salutis is salvation, perpetuae is like aeternae, it's everlasting. Donc, we offer, Preclare Majestati Tue, to your excellent majesty, we still speak to God the Father, De Tuis Donis Agdatis, from the gift you have given, this pure host, this holy host, this immaculate host, this holy bread of eternal life, and this chalice of everlasting salvation. The host is the victim. The host of the sacrifice is the victim. It means you can translate hostia, host, by victim. This pure victim, this immaculate victim, this holy bread for everlasting life, and this chalice of eternal salvation. Supraque propitio. Supra is upon, quae which, propitio ac sereno vultu respicere dineris. Dineris is deign. Respicere is to look. Quae is for this host, this victim, with this sacrifice we have offered. Donc, dineris, dein, respicere, look. Upon, quae this sacrifice, this victim, propitio ac sereno vultu. Vultu is the face. Propitio ac sereno. Sereno is serene. It means peaceful. Propitio is to be favorable. Now please look at this victim with a face of peace and favorable and peaceful. Donc, then to accept this sacrifice favorably. Et accepta abere, and make it accepted. Abere is to have it accepted. Sicut or sicuti as accepter abere dignatus est munera pueri tui justi abel. And then and accept, have this sacrifice accepted as you in the past time you receive the sacrifice of Abel the just. Because we know that in the Old Testament this sacrifice was pleasing to God. And we pray God that he can receive our sacrifice as he did of the one of Abel the just. We'll continue next time.
Now the Father.